Have you ever wondered what happens when a surgical procedure attempts to alter the human mind? Imagine a world where the scalpel's slice was once considered a cure-all for mental disorders. Welcome to the mysterious universe of lobotomy, a controversial surgical method that dared to venture into the uncharted territories of the human brain. It was once believed to be the magic bullet for mental health issues. Intrigued? Stay tuned as we journey through the intriguing history and uses of lobotomy. Let's take a step back to the late 1930s, where our story begins. In the heart of Portugal, a man named Dr. Antonio Egas Moniz is about to make a radical breakthrough. You see, Moniz was a neurologist with a theory that mental illnesses were not the result of some spiritual affliction or a malformation of character, but rather due to fixed and abnormal nerve connections in the brain. Now imagine the time, a world where mental health was a mystery, often misunderstood and stigmatized. Moniz, with his groundbreaking perspective, proposed a solution that was as radical as it was controversial, a surgical procedure to sever these abnormal connections, a treatment he called a lobotomy. His belief was that by disrupting these connections, he could alleviate the symptoms of mental illness. It was a bold move, a leap into the unknown, and it sparked a revolution in the field of psychiatry. And so, the controversial journey of lobotomy took off, promising a cure for mental illness. As we move into the 1940s and 1950s, lobotomy began to gain traction worldwide. The procedure, a drastic and invasive brain surgery, was seen as a revolutionary treatment for psychiatric illnesses. In the United States, the torchbearer of this technique was Dr. Walter Freeman, a neurologist who believed in the power of lobotomy to transform lives. Dr. Freeman performed thousands of these surgeries, often with a cavalier approach that would be unthinkable today. One of his most notorious cases was that of Rosemary Kennedy, the sister of future President John F. Kennedy. The procedure, intended to curb her mood swings, left her in a permanently incapacitated state, a poignant reminder of the risks involved. While the lobotomy was gaining popularity, it was also sowing seeds of its own downfall. The advent of antipsychotic drugs in the mid-1950s offered a less invasive way to manage mental illnesses. Suddenly, the necessity of a procedure as extreme as lobotomy was called into question, but perhaps the most significant blow to the practice came from the ethical concerns it raised. The idea of physically altering a person's brain to change their behavior sparked debates about the sanctity of personal identity and the limits of medical intervention. By the 1970s, lobotomy had fallen out of favor, leaving behind a controversial legacy. It served as a stark reminder of the lengths humanity will go to in the quest for understanding and treating the mind. Fast forward to the present day, what remains of lobotomy? Today, the practice of lobotomy has largely been relegated to the annals of medical history. However, its legacy is far from forgotten. Lobotomy is often remembered as a troubling chapter in psychiatric treatment, a chilling reminder of how far we've come in our understanding of mental health. In the realm of neurosurgery, lobotomy's influence can't be understated. It laid the groundwork for modern neurosurgical procedures, sparking a revolution in the way we approach the human brain. Then there's the intriguing case of Egas Moniz, the pioneer of lobotomy, who received the Nobel Prize for his work. This decision sparked a great deal of controversy, highlighting the ethical complexities in the field of medical advancements. Despite its dark history, lobotomy helped shape our understanding of the brain and mental illness, reminding us of the importance of ethical considerations in medical advancements.